ladies, okay? But before we get into that, I am Chanel with Lizzie's Charm, and yes, thank you so much for being here. I am a mystic diviner and metaphysician, okay? So yes, some things have changed, but not really. So we're gonna get into that. We're gonna talk about it, talk about a few things, and as I'm talking, I'm gonna be putting some stuff together and sharing that with you all. What's up, baby?
Can you join me?
No, not right now. I'm sorry. Come back and I'm gonna let you know in a little bit, okay? And so, yeah, y'all. As I've been away, I've been taking care of some things, watching a few things that I'm gonna talk about as well. But for right now, I'm going to share this, what I have going on. So today is Friday, it's Venus Day, okay? And Friday's Venus, it's about love and, you know, healing, health, relationships, wealth, all right, riches, money, pleasure, feeling good, okay, and all the things. So today I'm putting together a honey jar. I've actually been doing a series of work over this past week. So I started on Tuesday, then I did some work on Thursday, today's Friday, and I'm doing something on Sunday. So yeah, y'all gonna put this or come with me as I put this honey jar together. So I'm gonna share what I have going on, because the way the camera's set up is I don't have the space to show what I'm doing as I'm doing it, as well as talk to y'all. So give me one second. So this is what we have. We have some clover honey here, and we have 11 herbs here and in the jar. All right, for the all the things, okay? And yeah, that is what we're doing. So we gonna, you know, these herbs have been blessed and I've spoken the spirit upon them and all of those things. And yeah, we're just gonna put the jar together and I'm gonna show it to you once it's done, and me lighting the candle and everything of that nature. Okay, so yes, we're gonna go ahead and get into this. So, well, first I'm actually going to put all these herbs in here, this mortar, and pestle it to blend everything together. All right, and then I'm gonna put a little smoke over it and give some thanks, say a little prayer, you know, all the things, and get that going. All right, so go ahead and light this. So yeah, as I've been away, I started school recently. I am getting my bachelor's in metaphysical sciences. So I am currently going to just be taking this course. It's going to lead up to a doctorate. And what I don't know yet, probably going to be something like parapsychology or something like that. Or paranormal sciences. I know I'm going to smoke this glass here. But yes, I'm going to be on my journey in doing that. And within that, this is basically, you know, me moving forward with things I have really planned. I have had planned for a really long time, you know, and yeah. Just expanding more, you know. So yes, I still do conjure, hoodoo, and root work. That has not changed, but what I see is my role in things are expanding much more than what they have been, you know, where I have been coming out of not boxing, because metaphysics is a very broad view of things. It's all encompassing of everything. It's basically recognizing how the spirit realm activates, animates the physical world. It's similar to animism, but it goes much more deeper. It entails the information aspect of things, you know, which is a lot of what it is for me, right? In human design, I'm a projector and I'm a profile 1-3. So when it comes to learning things, like, that's really it for me. I like to know. And it's so interesting. I mentioned it in a past video. There's something called gene keys. And in gene keys, my purpose is dynasm. And dynasm is metaphysics. And so I've been planning to go to school for metaphysical sciences for since the beginning of the year, right? I decided, like, you know what? I want to know more. And before this, I was more on a learning path of, like, I don't know enough, you know? If I don't know this, then I can't do what it is that I want to do. And now I'm coming from a place of, like, I just want to expand. It don't have anything, like, I would still be doing what I'm doing even if I didn't have everything with, you know, even if I'd had decided not to take that route. Because at one time, like a few months ago, I did say, like, I'm not doing this. I'm not going to school. I'm not going back to school. I'm not learning anything else. But I am. And I've started, I've begun, and I've been doing that for the past, month? So, yeah, I've just been getting into that. And it's so interesting, right? So, I'm sure most of y'all have seen it. I watched, what was it? They Cloned Tyrone, right? And so, I've been seeing a lot of different things on the internet in reference to it. And it's just been very interesting witnessing everybody's everything, right? And there was one particular someone's, I guess, tweets or something, I don't know, or maybe it's Facebook, maybe it was Threads. Either way, it was somebody posted it, sharing somebody else's something on Instagram. And so real quick, I'm going to take the jar and take these herbs that I've ground up, blessed and prayed over. I'm going to put them in a jar. All right. So, basically they were talking about how, you know, They Cloned Tyrone was about the stereotypes in reality and society. And I don't disagree with that, but it's like, is it stereotypes or is it archetypes? And I say that because if we think about the pimp, the hoe, and the drug dealer, the pimp, there is a fine line when it comes to the higher expression and the lower expression, the higher octave, the lower octave of that, right? From something going from an archetype to a stereotype, right? So in reality, like, if we think about it, the stereotypes are that in the same of an archetype, right? Because it is an expression of being, an expression of self. And there is there is nothing that we witness outside of ourselves that doesn't live within us, right? So we can feel however we want to feel about it, but there is a part of that expression that exists within. It is a collective consciousness of oneness, right? So there is never not that part of you that exists. It may not be expressing itself, okay, but it does exist. It is there, okay? So so we have the herbs here. I'm not using a lot of herbs here, a lot in quantity, I should say, but I'm going to save a little bit for the candle that I'm going to burn on top of the jar. So we're going to add the cinnamon stick and the ginger, okay? And then we have the petition here, and I'm fold it and put it in there, okay? So with that, if we look at the pimp, right, the pimp is just that step down from the priest, right? Because the priest in itself, he is surrounded by women, the nuns, right? Looking at this from a Catholic perspective, surrounded by women, the nuns, who do his work for him, You know, granted, you know, of course he has his other priests around him, his altar crew and everything like that, but he also consorts with the divine feminine in order to make amends, because it is the government, church in itself is a government organization, right? It is a tax-free kind of entity that carries out its work and receive its money finances from the government if they so choose to, right? But of course tithe and offerings come in and into play and do what it is that does, right? And the pimp, he also has the women that's surrounding him carrying out his work for him, but on the streets. So with that, it's not really any different, because he is on some, I can save you, right? I can, we can get this money together, and you know, you're gonna give me a part of your money, right? And it's the same aspect, same correlation. And then when it comes to the whole in the surrounding area of things, the nun has basically, she has given her time, herself, her being away to something greater, right? Granted, the hoe is for pleasure, it's for money, it's to the pimp, it's for her commitment, her loyalty, right? But none, it's for her loyalty to Christ, to God. It is for her commitment, you know, to her priest, right? It is her commitment to the church, to the community, to the people. And when it comes to the dealer, it is like the shaman, okay? The shaman is providing healing. He's providing conversation, insight, guidance. Granted, you may try and be like, and also the shaman is the mystic and the healer within one. Okay, so that is in the triad within that archetypal realm. So with that, we're gonna add the honey now. And with that, it is a lot of people, you know, they make friends with their dealer. The dealer, you go to the dealer, you having issues, you need some help, you need some support, okay? And he's gonna give you what you need to feel good, to feel better, you know, give you that healing, right? It's not too much difference between the healer and the dealer, all right? So we are basically recognizing how these archetypal energies play out on different levels and different realms of society. It's just one has been orchestrated for destruction, for what is the word, to degenerate, and the other is for a means of uplifting, right? Because we've all heard the story of the pimp who became the preacher, right? Okay. We've all heard the story of the hoe who went to church and became committed, because when we think about the church, it is based around, especially religion, of a person becoming a good person, a better person. All right. Carrying out their healing, be more compassionate, more loving, right? More forgiving, all right? More to be healed, okay? And not to be in this space of really feeling, thinking, or seeing things as a dead end for real, right? So with that, we are basically seeing this triad of the healer, because the hoe can even be looked at as the healer, okay? The same way that the dealer can, all right? And we can look at these three archetypal energies coming together as this triad of human expression, because again, none of these energies don't not exist within us, despite the fact of whatever it is that we want to see, say, feel, however, Okay, so here we have our honey jar. I know most people put a lot of different herbs, or I should say a large quantity of herbs, but I'm not. Okay, because this is going to get things done and make things happen how I want and how I need them to, because I declare and say so. All right. I'm in a covenant with the divine to make it so. And so it is. So, yes. Whew, I'll be right back, y'all. Okay, so yes, I'm about to go ahead and dress. I'm gonna put this little tea candle on top of the jar and like that on the little altar that I have put together over here. But yeah, so one thing I wanted to mention is that the pimp can also be looked at this as the mystic, right? Because the mystic is like an enigma, right? It's the one who just goes around and people don't really understand them. They don't really see where their power comes from, where their prowess comes from, like how you living and that's what you doing kind of thing, you know? Women who go into that industry, you know, they will choose a pimp. All right, they will connect with someone, a man, a madam, however, who can help them, right? And it's a very mystical, very, you know, again, enigmatic kind of way of going about, right? Because it's like, what do you see in him kind of thing? Like, I'm not asking this, but I'm sure someone else would. Like, you can do this on your own. Why do you feel like you need him, you know, or them, whoever? You know, so it's a very ethereal type of energy that's going on with them. So we got the mystic, the pimp, the healer, the hoe, the shaman, the dealer, right? Who is to the healer, right? The shaman, though, has the mystic and the healer within him. Okay, so yeah. I wanted to talk about that because I was like, oh yeah, we could say it like that. But at the same time, yeah, we do allow these things to be kept up out of being influenced by what's going on and really not knowing, right? We can't, not everybody is here to know, to understand, to connect in that way. And I get the upset in being disgusted by it. So this is the conjure oil, fast luck oil I am using for these herbs, but you know, at the same time, like, you can be out on the internet twiddling your thumbs, but if, granted, sure, everybody got social media these days, but if you're not out connecting with nobody in real life, like, not saying you're not helping anybody if you're online. What I am saying, though, is that it's only so much that can happen behind the computer, behind a phone screen, and all of those things. Okay, granted, I know a lot of hood folks who have been online on YouTube and doing their thing. All right, they got a whole black and beef sector on YouTube. Okay. But at the same time, when it comes to that, like, most of the time people not listening because of the comfort it is that they are in within their realm of things, within their realm of going and doing, you know, in making do of everything it is that exists within their world. You know, I don't know. I'm in a place where it's just like, you know, things are going to be what they are until they change. Because if anything, there's nothing more inevitable and things changing, things evolving, things growing, blooming, and blossoming into something different. Granted, sometimes that changes death, right? And that brings an end to something, which destruction of things must take place in order for you to come to a new place of being. You know, it's inevitable. All right, things must be let go of in order to grow from, you know. It's kind of like if how farmers, they when they move their cattle from one pasture of land to another, they put flames to all of that space. Why? Because basically there needs to, it's the fire, the destroying, the destruction of that field that has grown, that cultivates fertility within the soil so it can grow more robust, more lush, more mineralized, right, and full for the cows to continue to grow and be nurtured with. It's similar, very same. Okay, so yeah, y'all, I didn't have a lot to say. I just wanted to share that. I just thought that was interesting. Okay, I'm gonna share these last few little steps. I'm gonna show y'all after I have the candle lit and everything going on there. And yes, I hope that you have a beautiful weekend that is restful, easeful, okay, and that things come forward for you in perfect ways, okay, exceeding ways, okay. So yeah, for those of you who are in seeking for some insight, some advice, some guidance, definitely book a reading with me. It's on the website below, okay. If for those of you who are wanting some insight when it comes to you doing your own personal work, you can also book a consultation with me for that. All right, and those of you who are in need of some conjure work done for you, check that out on my website. Everything is linked below. And yes, I will talk to y'all very soon. And let's get on to this spark of the flame. All right. And the crystals we have here are tiger's eye, carnelian, emerald, rose quartz, and garnet. And I have the half of a selenite wand here and some water with a bay leaf in there for protection. Until next time. Oh, and I forgot to add, I really did enjoy the movie. I loved how in the end, you know, they just didn't end it on some, I don't know, like that this is the way it is kind of thing. There's nothing you can do. I really appreciated how, you know, they show that you can change. Things can change, right? You can move. You can travel beyond where it is that you are to open up to new formations, new horizons, new adventures, right? And really releasing and removing the resistance it is that you've had and held on to up until all this time that's been keeping you stuck, okay? And that it's really okay to go with the flow and follow your heart, all right? So, yeah, y'all, I just had to come share that.